Texas Tech is lined up for the opening kickoff. So here we go. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Houston's a team and a program that year in, year out's got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got two, and they've got that huge offensive line. And, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact that you throw the ball.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play-action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
He makes his way to about the 38, and he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
And he tackles him hard at the 21.
First down.
Come on out here. Come get some. Come get some. Come out here. Come get some.
Run. Brought down at the 10.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
Man wide open, in and out of his hands. From the 10-yard line, it's second down. Got a man tackled for a loss. That's a loss of 4 yards.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
This is the 8th play of the drive. They come out on an empty backfield.
Here we go.
Excellent open field tackle. That was a good pass and catch there, but still not enough for the first down.
That's not an easy conversion here on third down for the offense. All the defense has to do is stay back, keep everything in front of them, come up and make a tackle.
The kick is up, and they tack on 3 points.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Run of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. They'll bring him down around the 30-yard line. He's scrambling. He's taken down around the 31-yard line.
Gain of 1 on the play. That makes it 4th and 4.
And this one is a beauty. Brought down at the 30.
You're always looking for the home run return, the big highlight. Didn't happen there, but he still got him a couple yards.
It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Houston is up by 3. And they make the stop right around the 40.
Number 23 brings him down to the 40-yard line. That makes it 1st and 10.
passes left, gets it out to the halfback, and he's tackled at the 44.
Well-designed route and a confidently thrown football by the quarterback. You need those things to make any offense work.
Tackle at the 47-yard line.
Makes the tackle. That's good for a gain of 9 yards. First down.
Dangerous throw. This one's picked off. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. To the 20. And he's taken down around the 16-yard line. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line.
Mike 50. Guys, game situation. Let's go. Set. Ten.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Down in the open field.
No gain on the play. That makes it 3rd and 7.
Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown.
A good football team has to consistently be able to capitalize when they're in the red zone.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A short 3-play, 15-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. Red Raiders are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you've talked to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down.
Tackle made around the 40-yard line.
Number 4 on the tackle at the 40-yard line. First down.
He's got an opening. He's tackled at the 50-yard line.
Had a gain of 10 yards. That makes it 1st and 10.
Mike 7. Watch the curls.
Jack, 98 Weasel.
Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up, and something good may just happen.
2nd down and 10 to go. Ball on the 50-yard line. There's a strike complete. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, it's a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice gain.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. First down.
I got you, boy. Mike 7.
Easy.
And down he goes at about the 37-yard line.
That brings up 2nd and 9.
Mike 7. Let's go.
Easy. Buffalo.
And he's tackled right away.
Mike 7. Hey, that's trap.
Let's go.
That's a great tackle at the 18. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Ready.
He gets out to about the 15-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards.
10th play of the drive.
That makes it first and 10.
Fires out to his wideout, and he's hit immediately. Looks like we're going to have a good game on our hands after one. Texas Tech's up by 4. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. In the shotgun and 5 wideouts.
Let's go! Green 95!
Throws it and it's caught for the touchdown. Trying to go up by 3, they'll kick the extra point. So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
The ruling on the field stands.
So after some discussion, the call on the field stands. Houston is up 2. And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Right, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Throws it in a hurry. Brought down around the 27-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
After a decent run up the gut.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
Disco Raver! Disco Raver! Disco Raver!
They'll bring him down around the 41-yard line. Out of bounds at the 45.
Game of 4 on the play.
You ain't doing
that makes it 2nd and 6.
You ain't doing nothing today.
Mike 50.
Alert, 54. Cat.
54. That's good for the 7 yards. First down.
Defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
It's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. He's taken down at the 38-yard line.
That's a deep 10 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and inches.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And they make the stop around the 29-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Catch, first down, he's knocked out. takes it out to about the 8-yard line. Strike to his receiver, no good. So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home.
2-4-7.
Let's make these babies cry.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's pushed out of bounds at the 5-yard line.
Gain of 3 on the way. Fourth down.
Texas Tech is looking to tie things up. It's up, and he's got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Complete, and he's out of bounds.
Gain of 14 on the play.
He don't know no better.
That makes it first and 10.
Mike, 7.
Fires out to his receiver. He's knocked out of bounds at midfield.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards.
7 to Mike. Mike, 7.
First down.
Around the 48-yard line. That'll be a 2-yard gain.
Once the wide receiver made the catch, he just kind of ran out of real estate. There was nowhere for him to go.
Tries to set up a screen for the wide receiver. Loss of 5 there.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. Throws it to the halfback on the screen, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 42. You don't need 3 guesses to figure out what they're going to run right here on fourth and short. Room around the corner. He's at the 30, makes it to the 27.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Gets it. He's in space. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
Ready!
Touchdown, Cougars! He makes the PAT. So a 9-play, 76-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Caught, open field, and he's tackled right around the 40. Caught, and he's hit immediately. Texas Tech's going to take their first time out of the half. from their own 43-yard line. Second down. He might not be able to get the pass off. They bring him down. Defense hoping for another sack here on third and long.
Larry, Larry, Larry! Let's go, Mike 50, Mike 50!
Set us the run!
And he's immediately tackled.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big gain, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
He really got a hold of that one. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The Cougars obviously have built their offense around this guy, and through two quarters, everything's working, Herbie, but, you know, you can't just rely on one guy, and he's got to be careful a little bit in the third and fourth quarter, too.
Well, you want to keep pushing. I mean, he's off to a great start. This offense is obviously off to a great start. It's a four-quarter game, and, you know, the opponent's going to try to get back into this game, take some chances. So if this running back is smart, he'll continue to challenge himself, his offensive line, and the entire offense. Continue to try to put more points up on the board.
Houston up 7 points. And he hits him hard at the nine.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit, whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
He gets out to about the 17-yard line. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards. Certainly, they don't have the return on here. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He heaves it deep. Caught by the sophomore. He's hit and taken down. Spikes the ball. From the 10-yard line, second down. Throws a strike over the middle. Touchdown, Red Raiders. That's his second touchdown catch of the game.
The quarterback knew exactly where to put the pass, and the receiver went out there and made the grab. Good communication there.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he hits the PAT. So a short three-play, 54-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. Good game here, 17-17. Texas Tech gets set to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Runs it and tackled in the backfield. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one.
How about the hit by the defender? Just a great job of pursuing the ball. That's how you finish off a tackle.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. So we've played two quarters. This game is all tied up, 17.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. These two defenses so far, they've been everything they've been advertised to be. They've stopped the run. They've limited the passing game. They apply pressure at the right time. It's going to be hard to find holes to move the ball at all in the second half.
Yeah, and sometimes it's really bad offense. And sometimes you can also look at those holes and they come open and all of a sudden they close really fast. And that's what you're seeing. A lot of guys that are really athletic, really fast. They know where to be. A lot of guys that you'll be seeing playing on Sundays. I mean, it's just a lot of talent to overcome, and you got to be in the right position. But then you got to beat those great players that are also in the right position. So I expect more of the same. But, you know, which team can break through and make a huge play to take the other one, you know, off guard a little bit and make that big play?
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm
going
to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kurt.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect.
Here he goes.
Nice run up the middle. Out of bounds, the 33-yard line. And the corner on the interception. To the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Houston. So a great play by the defender to give his team 6 points.
That was a very good play, and that will certainly help build his team's momentum.
And he converts the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And they can forget about returning this one. Let's see how the defense responds now, coming off that big play just a moment ago.
Brad, it's very important that this offense put that last possession behind them and just focus on trying to put together some positive plays right now and see if they can put a drive together.
From their own 25-yard line. It's second down, and they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the 5-wide set. And he almost has the INT.
Number 4 was the intended receiver on the play. That brings us 3rd and 10.
Mike's 50.
Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line.
That'll bring up 4th and 13.
He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. And down he goes at the 34. Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. Houston is up by a touchdown. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football, or check it down, or take off and run with it.
Incomplete. It's knocked down by the defense. From their own 34-yard line, it's 3rd down.
The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. And this one is a beauty. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He goes out of bounds at the 22. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle at the 28-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And they push him out at the 38. Steps out at the 43.
Gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and nine.
From the 43-yard line, it's second down.
Hey, Mike's 50, Mike's 50.
It's recovered. That's a pretty big mistake, and this offense will lose possession of the football.
Sloppy job by the ball carrier. First and foremost, you should always be concerned about the ball.
So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
He's tackled at the 29. The running back gets two on the carry.
That was a great tackle. The defender seemingly came out of nowhere and put a big hit on the ball carrier.
He's out of bounds, right around the 26-yard line. And he's taken down at the 16.
Number 24 makes the tackle at the 16-yard line. First down.
Swings it out left to the halfback.
Second and seven.
Hey, check Mike 50. Mike is a 50.
check.
Disco Raver.
Disco Raver.
25.
Fires out to his wideout. Here's an opening. Shows some moves and he's in. The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count.
Red, two, yellow, three.
Brought down at the 39. About the 49. So at the end of the third quarter, good game, 24-24.
That'll make it second in inches.
All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Run up the middle.
Gain of six on the play. That makes it first and ten.
Easy, easy.
He's taken down around the 43-yard line.
That's a gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
And he carries the ball for a nice
gain.
Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete.
The deflection prevented them from getting any yards, and now it's fourth down.
They'll call on the field goal unit. It's up, looks long enough, and he got it. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. And they make the stop around the 22-yard line.
That brings up second and 13.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on their own 22. He's going to try and scramble. And he has it on the corner. They'll bring him down at the 28.
That makes it 37.
And he's tackled at the 37. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's tackled right away.
Number 23 takes it. 35-yard line. That'll bring up second and 12.
It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 35. That's a great tackle at the 24.
Loss of 11 yards on the play. That'll bring up third and long.
They come out in a 5-wide set.
You can't block me. You can't block me.
Steps up. He airs it out. Swatted away.
His receiver didn't have much of a chance to make a play on the ball, so credit the defender for breaking it up.
That makes it fourth and long.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. It's away, and it's a booming punt. He's to the 40. They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
From their own 41-yard line, second down. Pass to the tight end, but he bottles the ball away.
Number 89 was the intended receiver on the play. That brings us third and 10.
I'm sure the coaches are going to tell him to calm down and be more careful because I guarantee you, nobody keeps throwing those passes into the defense like that without making a mistake.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Drill at the 16-yard line.
You know, I think that time, Brad, the defense tipped their hand with the blitz. You could really see the blitz was coming, and when an offense at this level knows that there's pressure coming, they can make the proper adjustments and then put those wide receivers in one-on-one opportunities against the defense. And when you blitz, you're really leaving yourself vulnerable to a big play against a good offense.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Touchdown, Cougars. The Cougars are so confident every time they hand this kid the football that he's going to do something special.
Well, there's a reason he's the go-to man. And here, with everything at stake, he's able to deliver for them in a big way.
And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for six that time.
Not a whole lot of time left in this game, Brad. They've got to score down two possessions, and they need to score as fast as they can and then recover an onside kick and hope to be able to have a shot to tie this game.
And he hits him hard at the 19-yard line.
That's a loss of 6 yards. That'll make it second and long.
Spikes the ball. Third down and what they didn't want to get in. Ball on the 19-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. He gets to 100 yards receiving with that grab.
Even when he isn't open, the quarterback will still throw him the ball and just let him make a play. It really shows the trust that the quarterback has with his receiver.
deep, lays it out there.
He hauls it in and gets out of bounds. So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was inbounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So the call on the field will be reversed. From their own 38-yard line, second down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He sails it long. The defender had it and then dropped it. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Throws it deep. This one will fall incomplete.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. He wants it all. So the play of the day, fourth and ball game, and the defense comes up with the stop of the day and what will be the win. Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Makes it out to about the 26. The Red Raiders using their third and final timeout. From the 26-yard line, first down. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock.
Let's go! Wide 88!
A yard, maybe two on the carry. Houston staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.